sheep and goat were the first animals to be domesticated for meat. Archaeologists have found human herding sheep and goat around 10,000 years ago in the Zagros Mountains of Iran and Iraq. The herding of sheep and goat spread through Africa and Asia as they could survive on the sparse vegetation of the dry mountainous areas. Many of us are unaware of the fact that goat meat is actually called chavon, while meat from an adult sheep is called mutton. But in a tropical country like India, where goats outnumber sheep, we use the term mutton for goat meat. Contrary to the popular belief, goat meat, though being a red meat, has low fat content, cholesterol content and calorie content, and thus is compared healthier even to chicken. Thus, with its high protein and iron content, goat meat is the healthiest existing red meat.
For a Bengali, Sundays are reserved for mutton curry. So let's prepare a dish of mutton curry with potatoes.
For this recipe, we require generous amount of onion. I can vouch on one thing, that this is the easiest existing recipe of mutton curry with basic pantry ingredients. I have taken 4 to 5 medium sized potatoes cut into halves, and I'll sprinkle some turmeric and salt on them before I'll fry them up. Now comes the most important part of cooking this dish, which is marination. This is the most important step, because in this step we'll be adding all our ingredients which we'll use to cook this dish. After adding up all the ingredients, we will use our hand and mix the mutton with the ingredients properly. This can be done very well by hand. You can also use a spatula if you want. So after we have mixed our mutton with our ingredients, we will take a thick bottom pan. A thick bottom pan is required to cook this recipe, because we'll be cooking the mutton on a low flame for a prolonged period of time. And we'll pour some mustard oil, and into the mustard oil we'll add our potatoes, and we need to fry them up lightly. In the same pot, using the residual oil, we will add our whole spices. Now, we'll temper the oil with whole spices, and after frying them up for around 10 to 20 seconds, we'll add our mutton into it. We haven't added any water as of now, but we can see that the onions and the tomatoes have started releasing their juices. The mutton will cook very well and will become very flavorful by being cooked in the juices of onions and tomatoes. Throughout the preparation of this dish, we'll keep the flame at low or medium. We'll cover and cook the mutton and keep checking on it at regular intervals. We have been cooking the mutton for almost 40 to 45 minutes, and we can notice that the tomatoes and the onions have released all their juices and the pan has already become dry. So now we'll add our potatoes, and after stirring it for a minute more, we'll add water to it. After adding the water, there are two ways to cook this dish. One is time consuming and has a superior taste. Another is a shortcut but has a good taste as well. Shortcut method is transferring it to a pressure cooker and let it cook for 2 to 3 whistles. The longer process involves covering it and cooking it on the same pan for 30 minutes more or till the mutton is totally cooked through. Our mutton curry has been cooking for around 1 hour 45 minutes now. The potatoes are also cooked properly. The collagen from the meat has made the gravy gelatinous. We can never achieve this consistency of the gravy and this rich taste on a pressure cooker. Our mutton curry is almost cooked now. Depending on the quality of meat, the cooking time varies. However, it usually ranges between 1 hour 45 minutes to 2 hours. Mutton curry tastes best with rice, yuchis and parathas.
Hi guys, I hope you love our content. I have a good news for all my viewers. Podity Band has collaborated with us and they are going to provide us with the soulful music. So while you enjoy my videos and cook the recipes, please do listen to their songs. And we upload a new video every Wednesday. So please do like, share and subscribe.